G'day, welcome to Evention. I'm your host, Dom Schran. Today, we're talking about drifting in the show jump ring. Speaking of drifters, I got boy Martin here helping us out. Let's get to it. G'day. So when we talk about drifting, we're talking about as the horse leaves the ground to go over the jump, him swinging his shoulders one direction or another. Ideally, we want the horse to stay perfectly straight. And so today, I'm going to teach you three useful tools to help straighten the horse. But first, let's see drifting in action. Okay, so I've got Boyd. He's going to come around here to demonstrate exactly what happens when the horse drifts over the jump. As you can see, as the horse went over the jump, he was drifting to the right. All right, guys, so let's talk about some ways to solve this issue. I've got three tools for you today. The first one, using an open rein. So as we go over the jump, and for example, the horse wants to drift right, we open our left rein to help counteract the drift. That's the simplest and easiest one to use. Second tool, use of the apex pole. Now what we are doing here is placing one end close to the center of the jump and we rest the other end out from the side of the jump. Now, when you're doing this, be careful that you don't try and stick it in the middle too soon because some horses might find this quite spooky. Also, you would like to use something like plastic, like we're using here, so that if the horse was to hit it, he's not going to hurt himself. So that's the apex pole, which brings us to our last, the landing pole. So what I've done here is I've put this rail a little to the right of where I want the horse to land. So this is correcting a horse with a right drift. Now, don't put this too close to the middle because we certainly don't want the horse to land on it. But the idea is that as he's going over the jump and he wants to throw those shoulders right, he spots the landing rail and goes, oh, I don't want to go there, and it pushes his shoulders back to where they should be, straight. So these are three easy to use tools. You can use all three of them together or just one, depending on how bad the drift is. But let's see this in action and see if it corrects our horse's drift. Okay, so I've got Boyd coming around again, although this time we're using our three steps for correcting the drift. Let's see if he jumps it a little straighter. Very good. So you can see the horse was much straighter over the fence and he's gonna make a much better shape as he jumps when he's that little bit straighter. Okay, so after seeing that, we can appreciate that by straightening the horse, we're gonna improve his jump. Now, onto our Evention tip of the day.
Well, Shramo, thanks for having me on the show today. Today I've been asked to give my tip of the day as the special guest. And one of my tips of the day would be always have someone on the ground helping you and watching you when you jump. I'm lucky enough to have my good neighbour and compatriot from Australia, Shramo, here, and we're always sort of jumping in the ring together or setting fences for each other and bouncing ideas off each other. And it doesn't matter how good you are, the person on the ground can sometimes see things that that you're not aware of as the rider on top of the horse. So my tip of the day is always have eyes on the ground.
So hopefully you picked up a few tools to help you when your horse is drifting. And that wraps up the episode, as well as 2012. From all of us here at Evention, we'd like to thank you for joining us, and we look forward to working with you next year.